Congratulations, my friend. I can't ignore it. I can only celebrate it with you, bro. So deserve it. You and Trent Atticus for such great work, man. Well done.
Bruh, that was so heavy to see the reception of the film around the world. It's crazy. It's crazy, man. Cause we it brought so many people together, man. I'm so proud and humbled. Thank you, Zane. How you feeling, brother?
I'm feeling good, man. You know, I'm starting 2021. You know, I'm encouraging positive manifestation and destiny that is outside of this current situation on so many levels. I feel grateful to be alive, and I feel grateful to be able to conduct conversations, ask questions, and talk to really smart, thoughtful, compassionate people like yourself, bro. So I'm happy to see you.
Man, you the man, bro. I love you, man. It's so good always when we get a chance to talk. And this time is crazy because I feel like we're all changing. Our internal life is evolving. And we're evaluating so many things and so many questions that we probably wouldn't have had the time in this point in our lives to do.
I feel like that's what this album is about. I feel like we are, as you, bringing all of these different emotions and feelings and energies and movements all into one collective thought and saying, it's okay, I can cry, but I can also dance and I can also tell the truth. And there's so many things going on here. It's almost like a manuscript.
Yeah, that's a great way of putting it, man. I really do feel like it's a culmination of my life and so many of the different things that have gone into creating who I am today. I also just wanted to have something that captured the lineage. You know, I'm always thinking about taking the past, blending it with things in the present to create the future. I'm always forecasting the future. Like, I'm trying to think about, okay, if I was a musical archaeologist, but instead of putting things in a museum, I'm taking these things, these black forms of social music, and I'm bringing them into the present to create something anew. And it's the first time we ever will have had the chance in history to do that. We can blend things, indigenous forms of folk music, all of the stuff from the Chitlin circuit. We could put it with trap music. We could do stuff now and create the future.
So what did you learn making this record? As somebody who has learned so much so far and has the skill set to be able to even tackle a project like this covering so much ground, like I said, you know, historically, contextually, and creatively, what did you actually learn? What are you going to take into your next thing?
Man, look, I learned something from Quincy, who worked on the record with me. I talked to him throughout the process of the record, wrote the liner notes, and Quincy told me something Duke Ellington told him, which is we have to decategorize the music. I learned that I always felt it. I always thought it. I always felt it, but I didn't know it. That genres don't exist.
You know, this album really is a beautiful example of how to lean into the important conversation in a country that needs to hear them. And needs to be a part of those conversations and speak to one another and learn and understand. Living in America, singing, writing, performing, and communicating about that experience from your point of view as a human being on this planet. And then talking to Stevie and hearing what he has to say about his plans and how he's like, I'm going in a different direction. How has he communicated that to you without speaking on his behalf? What are you learning from him in terms of his next step in life?
You got to protect your energy. You got to protect your joy. You got to protect your love and you got to protect your community. Love, joy, and community are the things that I've just started to figure out are the key ingredients to what I'm all about, what I'm trying to communicate, and what all of the people who I love, like Stevie, and all of the ancestors who I've really studied and just in the whole game. That's really, those are the three major ingredients. You got to protect them. And if that means you got to go into a different space at this point in his life, you know, you got to go into the space where you know that you can protect those things. And some people that role is to be in the street, to be protesting, to be activating, creating, building. Other people, that role, they may have done that role already. I did this already. It's not my turn anymore. It's your turn.
You feel, though, as an artist releasing a record like this, like there is, like you have road to run in this country, that there's work to be done. You feel committed to that. You feel like that your voice and what you want to achieve here in the United States of America matters to you and therefore matters to what you're trying to say.
I think it matters because it's a human issue. It's so many things that we're talking about at once that is really nuanced, that the divisive conversation and the kind of polarizing way that we view things is destructive, because we come from these very nuanced, humans are nuanced. We have our earthly, fleshly nature, and we have our divine spiritual nature, art, music, culture, family, community. That feeds the spiritual nature. That feeds the divine nature. And bringing that to the conversation, coupled with the aspect of lineage that I come from and my understanding of what that means in a cultural context, I feel compelled to speak. It's almost a calling to speak and to be a leader in that way now more than ever. And that's really what pulled me into the streets back in the summer of 2020. You know, man, I didn't think about that. I had a lot of stuff that I probably, you know, if I would have thought about the network, if I would have thought about, because we didn't know what people were landing on the side of the fence on that time. But if I would have thought about it, I probably wouldn't have done it in the same way. You know, you're risking your life in a certain way as well. Police, violence, brutality, coronavirus, all these things. But I just, if I'm about all this stuff that I said I've been about since I've been out here, then I would be out there. And that was it. You know what I mean?
So you have a really defined internal compass, but there must be moments when even just the external chaos gets in the way and creates a layer that clouds your ability to see through things. How do you stay present in the moment? For someone who's a musical archaeologist who's using all of that to define the future, what does the present mean to you?
Well, the present is everything, because the power of the now is what allows us to create the future. The power of the now is the greatest power that we can use as creatives, because if we're present, that's where the possibilities are. The inspiration is in the past. The possibilities are in the now. So when you're looking at this, I mean, you know, Dre, I'm just thinking about people that I've worked with or seen work, like just the way that in the listening and the intention of the listening.
The focus, yeah.
It's so, so present that you almost dissipate. Yourself disappears and it just becomes the thing that you're focused on. And that to me is a great, great exercise, a meditation, a spiritual practice that I've tried to develop and keep up. And in some periods in my life, it's easier than others. You know, right now we're on the train, you know, we're promoting the film on the campaigns, we're doing the album promotion. So in these times, I find it that even if it's just five or 10 minutes in the morning or at night, just before bed, just to get into the present and in the presence and just, you know, just be there. But really, I don't have a method. I can't really ascribe anything to anybody or tell anybody what to do other than that. Yeah.
That's why I love that you did meditations last year, because to me, I feel like that was a step to making this record. What you and Corey did was kind of almost, I need this. I need to make something that allows me to be still before I can figure out what it is I'm really trying to say. Am I on the right path?
So perceptive that you see that, man. We made the record Meditations while making We Are, and we made it because we felt we needed to make it. It was during the breaks between making We Are. You know, I told you I love to have many different forms of stimulus happening at one time. And this was really a great example of that, that has manifested into a project. Meditations was the thing that I felt balanced, almost the yin and yang concept. It balanced all that was happening in the world, all that we were doing with the album and putting into We Are and all of the collaborators. You got over 200 musicians on, the artists, creatives, engineers, We Are. Meditations was Corey and I, our brother Nate, our brother Sam. Let's build this world and let's capture this world and let's share it with people.
Well, John, you know, I love you as a human being and as an artist from the minute I met you, man. I think you're such a unique presence on this planet at a time when you're needed. I can't help but feel some kind of spiritual destiny attached to you. You can't ignore it. The fact that, you know, your life has led you to this point where you're able to apply yourself in so many different ways and disciplines in order to do right by the three principles upon which you are committed, which, if I'm not mistaken, is love, joy, and community, correct?
That's it. You know, if you find a way to be yourself in this life, if you find a way to be yourself unbridled, unpretentious, authentic, and walk in that path, I guarantee that will enliven and empower so many people, that'll be your fuel to keep going. And I feel like I'm just getting in touch with and meeting the individual who was within all along. And that person, that's the connection to God and the divine that I'm trying to continue to grow and feed, even in these times that we're in, feeding that, growing that, building that out. So, man, to say that you see the spiritual calling on my life, that's the biggest compliment, because it's been a journey, and it's not been any journey that I've been able to see. You know, I've had mentors, I've had all kinds of great collaborators, but it's my own journey, and it's something that we all have to figure out if we're trying to reach that level of authenticity and that level of manifestation of who we actually are. It's going to be a unique road, and it's not going to be a road where you're going to see other people on it sometime for long stretches. So that's a great compliment that you can feel that and see that. That also says you're a seer. You know, I wrote something on the cover of the album to the seers, to the griots, to the truth tellers who refuse to let us descend fully into madness. And that's what madness is. That's what chaos and pandemonium is. That's what we see when people try to put us in these boxes, try to put us in these ways of thinking politically that's, you know, here or there, left or right, red or blue. Everything is this or that, black or white, woman. It's just, we're so, so much deeper than that. Everybody is so much more than that. And I feel that there's something that I have to say in this life to illuminate that. That is it. That's the community aspect. That's the love aspect. And ultimately, the joy that comes from that is knowing.